Good morning, students. Welcome to the session to learn about measurement of resistance. Under the subject electrical and electronic measurements with the subject code 18E36 under module 1, you have measurement of resistance, measurement of capacitance and measurement of inductance. Under measurement of resistance, you have Wheatstone bridge, sensitivity, limitations. Under Wheatstone bridge, you have the sensitivity and limitations, and Kelvin's double bridge, earth resistance measurement by fall of potential method, and earth resistance measurement by using Megger. Before we get into the subject to measure the resistance or the measurement of resistance, we'll have a look at what is the need for the subject, that is electrical and electronic measurements. What is the need? Why the subject is introduced? Why you need to learn about the measurement and instrumentation? Measurement is one of the important aspects of science. It is difficult to conduct experiments and form theories without the ability to measure. In today's world, everyone is talking about industrial automation, everywhere automation. Digital India, robotic process automation, everywhere you can hear the word automation. What is the basic need to make anything automated? You have the automated guided vehicle, that is driverless car. What is the basic necessity or basic need or the basic parameter or basic task which is needed to convert a particular task or a system into an automatic one, manual into automatic, how to convert into automatic. So for this, anything to be converted into automatic, first thing, you need to measure the actual what is available, present output. You need to measure the present status. Once it is measured, then that is processed, that is compared, whether whatever is measured, is it sufficient or to be improved or to be increased or to be decreased, then that is decided with the some basic threshold value. Based on that, by adjusting some of the devices or some of the parameters, you are making the things automatic. So the basic necessity or the basic thing is measurement, measuring the things, whatever it is, whether it is a voltage or the current or the power or the speed, that should be measured to correct it or to make the things automatic. So you can say it is one of the important aspects of science in your day-to-day life also. It is one of the important aspects. So here in this lecture, you are going to concentrate only on the measurement of resistance. Why there is a separate chapter for the measurement of resistance? So resistance or the resistor or the important parameter or the important property of any device. So measurement of resistance is the important one. In the real world, the parameters if you measure, maybe you want to measure the temperature, maybe you want to measure the pressure, you have the pressure transducer, you have the temperature transducer. So whatever it is, you have the basic element called with respect to the resistor. So you need to learn about how the resistance can be measured. So you have measurement of resistance here. How the resistance can be classified? So based on the nature of supply, it can be classified, or according to the value of resistance also can be classified. So as per the syllabus or with respect to the point of measurement, keeping measurement in mind, this can be classified into low, high, medium resistance. And according to the nature of supply also, it can be classified. So based on the nature of supply, this can be classified as DC resistance and AC resistance. Based on nature of supply, in which circuit the resistors are used, whether it is the DC circuit or in the AC circuit. Again, the question, what is the DC circuit? DC circuit is nothing but where the source of energy is DC. Where the source of energy is AC, it is called AC circuit. When the resistor is used in the AC circuit, it is called AC resistance. When it is used in the DC circuit, it is called DC resistance. So, based on the nature of the type of supply, it can be classified as DC resistance and AC resistance. According to the value of resistance. So, according to the value of resistance, can be classified as low resistance, medium resistance, and high resistance. With respect to the point of measurement, the resistors can be classified into low resistance, medium resistance, and high resistance. The resistance with the value very much less than 1 ohm. The resistance with the value less than 1 ohm, it is called the low resistance. Resistance value between the 1 ohm and 0.1 megaohm, that is 100K, it is called as a medium resistance. And the resistance greater than 0.1 megaohm, that is 100K, resistance value greater than 100 kilo ohm, that is called as high resistance. Next question is, why it is classified as low resistance or the medium resistance or the high resistance? Is the question now. So, according to the point of measurement, measurement methods or based on the measurement methods, it is classified. The measurement method used for measuring the low resistance may not be suitable for measuring the medium resistance. Or the measurement method suitable for the medium resistance may not be suitable for measuring the low resistance. Similarly for the high resistance also. So, certain type of methods which is particularly available for the low resistance are some type of methods available for the medium resistance are some methods, that is measurement methods, available for the high resistance or a particular range of resistance, low resistance, medium resistance and high resistance. Example for low resistance. So, under low resistance, you can see the armature resistance, the armature winding resistance that comes under category of the low resistance, that is below 1 ohm. Similarly, in the series field resistance, you come across DC generator or the DC motor separately excited, self-excited. Under separately excited, you have the series field winding or the shunt field winding. So, the series field resistance that comes under, or the value of that is less than 1 ohm, and the earth resistance, that electrode resistance, the earth rod resistance, again it is below 1 ohm. Next one is medium resistance, that is with the range between 1 ohm to 0.1 megaohm. So that you can give the example as the resistance of the long transmission lines comes under this medium resistance, that is between 1 ohm and 100K, and shunt field resistance. So series field resistance under low resistance, the shunt field resistance under medium resistance. Next, you have the high resistance. Under the high resistance, the resistance of the insulated disc of transmission line, or the resistance of the cable insulation, or any insulation resistance can be classified or will come under the category high resistance. Measurement methods. So, to measure the low resistance, you have the AV method, that is ammeter voltmeter method, Kelvin double bridge method, potentiometer method, and ohmmeter method, etc. So there are many methods available to measure the low resistance. So out of these four, Kelvin double bridge bridge method is the prescribed one or mentioned in your syllabus. So you are going to learn about Kelvin double bridge under the methods available for the low resistance. And for the medium resistance, you have the AV method, that is again ammeter, voltmeter method, Wheatstone bridge, substitution method, etc. So out of these three methods, Wheatstone bridge, as per your syllabus, you are going to see what is Wheatstone bridge, how this method is used to measure the medium resistance. Next, high resistance. So to measure the high resistance, that is with the value of 0.1 mega, greater than 0.1 mega, that is greater than 100 mega kilo ohms, to measure such high resistance, you have the ammeter voltmeter method, fall of potential method, Megger loss of charge method, substitution method, and bridge method, etc. So that's all about the measurement methods. We'll continue in the next session.